The year was 1887, a time when the Industrial Revolution was in full swing, transforming societies and economies around the globe. On the picturesque Vancouver Island, the bustling coal town of Nanaimo was thriving. The town was a hub of activity, with coal mining at its heart, providing livelihoods for many families. However, this prosperity was about to be overshadowed by an unimaginable tragedy. On May 3rd, a deafening roar echoed through the valleys, a sound that would haunt the memories of those who heard it. This roar signaled a catastrophic event that would forever scar the community and leave an indelible mark on its history. Deep beneath the earth's surface, in the dark and dusty tunnels of the Nanaimo coal mine, an explosion ripped through the shafts with a force so powerful that it shook the ground above. The miners, who had descended into the depths to earn their daily bread, found themselves trapped in a nightmare. 150 men and boys, who were simply doing their duty, had their lives tragically cut short. These were fathers, sons, brothers and friends, each with their own stories and dreams, all extinguished in an instant. The Nanaimo mine explosion stands as a stark reminder of the perilous nature of coal mining, particularly in the 19th century. The conditions were harsh, and the risks were ever present, with safety regulations being rudimentary at best. And the miners faced constant danger in their pursuit of the black gold that fueled a nation. The equipment was primitive, and the working conditions were often dire, with little regard for the well-being of the workers. The explosion sent shockwaves throughout the world, highlighting the human cost of industrial progress. Newspapers around the globe reported on the tragedy, bringing attention to the often overlooked sacrifices made by those who toiled in the mines. The Nanaimo mine explosion became a symbol of the need for better safety standards and the importance of valuing human life over industrial gain. In the heart of Nanaimo, the coal mine wasn't just a place of work, it was the lifeblood of the town. The mine's presence was felt in every corner, from the bustling main street to the quiet residential areas. It was a constant reminder of the town's identity and its people's resilience. Generations of families had toiled in its depths, their lives intricately woven into the fabric of the mine's existence. Fathers, sons and even grandsons found themselves following the same path, bound by tradition and necessity. The mine was more than a job, it was a legacy passed down through the ages. The rhythmic clang of pickaxes against the coal face, the rumble of carts laden with the black treasure, and the camaraderie forged in the face of danger were all part of daily life. Each swing of the pickaxe echoed with the hopes and dreams of those who wielded it. And the shared struggles created unbreakable bonds among the miners.
For many, the mine represented opportunity, a chance for a better life. It was a beacon of hope in an otherwise uncertain world, offering steady employment and the promise of a brighter future. The mine was a place where hard work and determination could transform lives. However, this opportunity came at a price. The work was arduous and fraught with peril. Long hours in the dark, cramped tunnels took a toll on the miners' bodies and spirits. The physical demands were relentless and the mental strain was equally taxing. The air hung thick with coal dust, making each breath a labored effort. The miners' lungs bore the brunt of this harsh environment, and many suffered from respiratory ailments. The ever-present coal dust was a silent enemy, slowly eroding their health. The ever-present threat of methane gas explosions and tunnel collapses loomed large in the minds of the miners. Each day brought new dangers, and the miners had to remain vigilant, constantly aware of the risks that surrounded them. Safety measures were in place, but the unpredictable nature of the mine meant that disaster could strike at any moment. Yet, they persevered, their determination fueled by the need to provide for their families. The miners' resilience was a testament to their strength and dedication. They faced each challenge head-on, driven by the love and responsibility they felt for their loved ones. In the face of adversity, they found solidarity and support in one another, creating a community bound by shared experiences and unwavering resolve.
The morning of May 3rd began like any other. The sun rose slowly, casting a golden hue over the sleepy town of Nanaimo. Birds chirped their morning songs, and the townsfolk began their daily routines, unaware of the impending disaster that would soon unfold. Miners descended into the darkness, their lamps flickering like fireflies in the gloom. These men, hardened by years of labor, were the backbone of the town's economy. Each day they ventured into the bowels of the earth, driven by the need to provide for their families and fuel the nation's industrial growth. They worked diligently, extracting the coal that powered the burgeoning industries of the nation. The rhythmic sound of pickaxes striking rock echoed through the tunnels, a testament to their relentless effort. The coal they unearthed was more than just a resource. It was the lifeblood of progress, feeding the engines of factories and railways. Little did they know, an invisible danger lurked within the mine. The air, though seemingly harmless, was a silent predator. The miners, focused on their tasks, were oblivious to the peril that surrounded them. Their faces, illuminated by the dim glow of their lamps, showed no sign of the catastrophe that was about to strike. A buildup of methane gas, undetectable to the human senses, had created a ticking time bomb. Despite the presence of safety equipment, the insidious gas had accumulated over time, waiting for the slightest trigger to unleash its destructive force. The miners' lives hung in a delicate balance, teetering on the edge of disaster. At approximately 2 p.m., the silence of the mine was shattered. The tranquility of the day was abruptly replaced by chaos. A deafening roar echoed through the tunnels and the ground shook violently. The miners, caught off guard, had no time to react as the explosion ripped through the mine. A spark, perhaps from a miner's lamp or a faulty piece of equipment, ignited the volatile gas. The chain reaction was instantaneous, a deadly dance of fire and force. The once stable environment of the mine was transformed into a hellish inferno, with flames and debris engulfing everything in their path. The resulting explosion tore through the tunnels, sending shockwaves that shook the very foundations of Nanaimo. The force of the blast was felt far and wide, a grim reminder of the power that lay hidden beneath the earth. The town, once peaceful and serene, was now a scene of devastation and despair. The earth trembled, buildings rattled, and a plume of dust and debris erupted from the mine shaft, painting the clear sky black. The townspeople, witnessing the horror unfold, could only watch in helplessness. The once clear sky was now obscured by a thick, choking cloud, a somber testament to the tragedy that had befallen their community. In the immediate aftermath of the explosion, chaos reigned. The air was thick with dust and the stench of explosives. The cries of injured men echoed through the darkness, their pleas for help swallowed by the mine's suffocating embrace. Yet, amidst the devastation, stories of courage and survival began to emerge.
William Edwards, a young miner who had just begun his shift, found himself miraculously unharmed. Navigating through the wreckage and darkness, he stumbled upon a group of injured comrades. Together, they helped each other towards the surface, their journey illuminated by the faint glow of Edwards's lamp.
Section 5. Whispers from the dust final messages. As rescuers bravely ventured into the shattered remnants of the mine, they were met with a scene of unimaginable devastation. The once familiar tunnels were now twisted and collapsed, the air heavy with the stench of death. It was during these harrowing recovery efforts that a poignant discovery was made. On the walls and support beams, etched into the coal dust by trembling hands, were messages from the trapped miners. These poignant last words, some filled with love for their families, others expressing resignation to their fate, serve as heartbreaking reminders of the human cost of the tragedy. Section 6. The aftermath, a community in mourning. The Nanaimo mine explosion cast a long shadow over the once vibrant community. The loss of 150 souls, many of whom were fathers, sons, and brothers, left an unfillable void in the hearts of the townspeople.
Grief-stricken families gathered at the mine entrance, their faces etched with sorrow as they waited for news of their loved ones.
The explosion had a profound impact on Nanaimo's social fabric. The loss of so many breadwinners plunged many families into poverty. The emotional toll was immeasurable, as widows and children struggled to come to terms with their loss and face an uncertain future. Section 7, the forgotten miners, Chinese workers and discrimination. In the wake of the Nanaimo mine explosion, a tragic tale of social injustice unfolded. Among the victims were a significant number of Chinese workers who played a vital role in the mine's operation.
However, their contributions were often overlooked, and in death, they faced discrimination. Many Chinese miners were not afforded the same respect as their Caucasian counterparts. Their names were often missing from official records, and their families received little to no compensation for their loss.
This blatant disregard for their lives and sacrifices highlights the racial prejudices that permeated society at the time. Section 8, Rising from the Ashes, the mine's reopening and eventual closure. Despite the devastating loss of life and the emotional scars left by the explosion, the Nanaimo coal mine eventually resumed operations. The demand for coal remained high, and the community, desperate for economic recovery, reluctantly returned to the very place that had brought them so much pain. However, the mine's productivity never reached its pre-explosion levels. The memory of the tragedy lingered, casting a somber pall over the operation. As the 20th century dawned and alternative energy sources emerged, the Nanaimo coal mine gradually declined in importance. Section 9, Remembering the Fallen Memorials and Legacy. The Nanaimo mine explosion serves as a solemn reminder of the human cost of industrial progress. Over the years, the community has come together to honor the memory of those lost in the tragedy, ensuring that their sacrifices will never be forgotten.
In 1987, on the 100th anniversary of the explosion, a poignant memorial was unveiled in Nanaimo. The memorial, a towering granite obelisk inscribed with the names of all 150 victims, stands as a testament to the enduring legacy of the disaster. It serves as a place of remembrance and reflection, where visitors can pay their respects and learn about the event that shaped Nanaimo's history.